Test 1, 2, 3.
Watch it. Watch it. See, see that light?
Okay, good morning, everybody. Welcome to this first meeting of the school year. We have a short agenda this morning, so I suspect we'll be able to conduct the business fairly efficiently. But just to start, we did get regrets from Member Quinn and Councillor Wilkinson, which is okay, because, again, we don't have a deep agenda. Any declarations of interest? I see none. Confirmation of minutes from the 11th July 2016 meeting. Are those carried? Great, great. Okay, so the first item on our agenda is a postponement and deferral from our June meeting. This was an application for new construction at 667 Bank Street. And you recall at the time that the applicant expressed a willingness to extend the legislative deadlines in order to try and harmonize the various planning applications that were required for this file. And over the course of the summer, the developments have been that it's felt the applicant feels that a little bit more time is required. And because there are various parts to this puzzle, including a UIDP meeting last week and work towards site plan, et cetera, both the applicant and the planning staff are in agreement with the fact that this issue could be referred as opposed to deferred. And the difference is that referral allows staff to change or update their report should any of the developments or changes to the application occur. So the vice chair is going to introduce the motion of referral, but I wanted to give you that background as to why we're doing that in this case. Over to you, Mr. Vice Chair.
Yes, so I'm pleased to move that the Built Heritage Subcommittee refer this matter to staff with the request that the revised report be brought back to the Built Heritage Subcommittee in advance of December 31st, 2016, and in such time as to permit consideration by the Subcommittee, Planning Committee, and Council prior to the end of 2016.
So is that carried? Great, wonderful. So our next item in terms of our development review function is an application to alter the building at 263 Soper Place, a property designated under Part 5 of the Ontario Heritage Act and located in the Rockcliffe Park Heritage Conservation District. And I'm going to turn it over to Anne Fitzpatrick, who's going to give us a bit of a summary of this application.
Sure. So the application that's in front of you today is to alter the building at 263 Soper Place. The photos on the screen show the existing building today, which was constructed in 1999. Here is the garage of the existing building. The site plan here shows the proposed alterations include recladding the exterior in limestone, aircraft brick, and fiber cement panels, the construction of a two-story addition with a garage, modifying the fenestration pattern, relocating the front entry, and creating a new roofline. These are the elevations that depict those changes. The proposed landscape changes include the retention of all the mature trees and a small reconfiguration of the front walkway. The existing grades are to be maintained, and the proposed material for the pathway is interlocking pavers. Here are some renderings of the project. As you can see, it's a more contemporary building. The department supports the alterations. The use of primarily natural materials will complement materials found elsewhere in the district. The reduced height of the building and consistent orientation on the lot is compatible with its neighbors. And the contemporary design and the use of varied frames and glass to break up the massing meets the intent of the HCD guidelines.
Thank you very much for that. Any questions to staff on this application? Member Smollett and Councillor Mahut.
It's not a question. I would just say that the building would look somewhat out of context if it wasn't for the fact that there's a massive gold mansion across the street.
Thanks. One of the problems that has occurred over the years, and I noticed there was we got a letter this morning about the trees, and I just wondered when that kind of work has been done, what we've noticed sometimes is that people will park heavy construction material around the base of the mature trees. And I'm just, is the process, does that get inspected during the course of construction to ensure that the tree, the drip area of the tree is protected and that soil isn't compacted? Because I know if they just put like a cheap orange fence up, normally it gets knocked down. So I'm just wondering, that issue was raised here about protecting mature trees, and I just would like to make sure that that doesn't become an issue here. We've seen it before where the trees survive the construction, but then a year or two later they're dead as a result of compaction of the root area. So is that something that...
Is there a special treatment of trees in Rockcliffe Park during construction?
Yes, it's a case of not putting the cheap yellow fence that falls down, but putting a more robust, I think it's called, I forget what it's called, but it's a steel fencing.
Modulock?
It's something that you can't knock over.
There are no special requirements over and above the normal requirements at the during a construction project in Rockcliffe Park. I don't know. Maybe Ann can go back to the site plan to see whether there are, in fact, any mature trees that a machine could be parked near. And then in terms of inspection and going forward, we can certainly start to look at a requirement for a more robust tree protection program.
I guess that was my point. Yeah, if we could look, if there are mature trees and there is a risk, it has been a problem we've identified in the past that people do park construction equipment on it, and that will lead to compaction of roots and eventual death of the tree. So
yes, a lot
if there are mature trees, if you could look at that, that would be really helpful.
Yeah, and a lot of it also is a question of contractors, and because during inspections there are, if they are identified to be protected, so it is building a good relationship between the inspector and the foreman on the site, because sometimes you run into no problems but other times you do. So we will try to develop a higher standard.
Thank you.
Okay, seeing no other questions, there was one correspondence from a neighbor actually related to the issue of the health of the mature trees, but I think that's being in part answered, and I understand that the city forester has also looked at the application and deemed that the feeling was that the mature trees would be protected. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. We do have one delegation who's prepared to speak, Catherine Quachuta from FOTEN Consultants. Am I correct in assuming that if the committee is prepared to pass a recommendation, you don't need to speak?
That's correct.
Okay. So I'm not hearing any other questions or comments, so I will put this recommendation before the committee. And is the recommendation for approval carried? Great. Okay. Thank you. Okay, our next item on the agenda is a status update, the Built Heritage Subcommittee inquiries and motions for the period ending 26 August 2016. And the recommendation before us is that we receive this report for information. Is that received? Wonderful. There are no in-camera items. Are there any notices of motion or inquiries? Any other business? And I believe probably a record. I think we've just established a record, ladies and gentlemen, of the shortest meeting. But because I want, you know, at least one more minute, I am going to mention the fact that we have a couple of things. We've got some correspondence which was passed around. We also, of course, cannot forget the biannual Ottawa Architectural Conservation Awards, which are taking place on February 21st, 2017. The important point now, however, is deadline for applications is October 7th. So if you, as you walk and bike and transit and drive around the city, if you see lots of examples of interesting conservation heritage examples in our built environment, I would encourage you to put those forward for nomination. So with that, that's our other business. We are adjourned, and we'll see you in October. Thank you.